What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and I am back with the second tutorial in the PL SQL collection in Oracle database series. Today in this video we will learn what are nested tables and how to create them. So without further ado, let's get started and learn how to create nested tables in Oracle database. But first, let's start with a quick introduction. If I ask you to define what are nested tables, what is the simplest thing which comes to your mind? A table inside a table. Yes, indeed, this is the simplest definition one can think of. Also, it is exactly the name nested table suggests. A table which is embedded within another table is called nested table, right? If we have to define it more technically, then we can say nested tables are one-dimensional structure which are persistent and unbounded in nature. They are accessible in SQL and PLSQL and can be used in tables, records, and object definitions. Since it is an unbounded PL SQL collection, hence it can hold any number of elements in an unordered set. For those who have no idea what are persistent and unbounded collections, I have explained them in the blog post of the previous tutorial. You can find the link in the description. Now let's take a look at the syntax for creating a nested table in Oracle database. You can create a nested table either inside the PL SQL block or as a database collection type object. As both are the different aspects of creating the nested table, thus both carry different syntax. For example, here is the syntax for creating a nested table in PL SQL block. We create a nested table in the declaration section of the PL SQL block. In order to create a nested table in PL SQL, we use type statement, which start with the keyword type followed by the name of your table, which is user defined. Then we have a reserved phrase, which is table of, followed by the element type, which could be either any primitive data type or say PL SQL data type or a user defined type. Then at the end, we have an optional not null clause, which makes sure that your table doesn't have any null values. Now that we have seen the syntax, let's do some examples. Like always, I will try not to make it too fancy and keep it simple yet helpful to you. So let's create a nested table in PL SQL block. Server output it's set to on so that we can see the return values. Let's stop here for a second and understand these three lines as they are going to form the base of this program. First line is just a declare keyword marking the beginning of the PL SQL block, which is obvious. In the next line, we created a nested table. In order to avoid the confusion, I named the table my nested table. And this table will hold the elements of number data type, which we are making sure by using the isTableOfReserved phrase. In the third line, we created a variable var_nt and used it to initialize the created table. To initialize the table and store the data, we first write the name of the variable followed by the name of the nested table with assignment operator. On the right hand side of the assignment operator, we again have the name of the nested table followed by the data we want to store into it enclosed inside the parentheses. Do make sure the data type of the data you pass to store into your table must match with the data type you mentioned while creating your nested table. Now that we have created and initialized the nested table, next we have to learn how to retrieve the values stored into it. So let's move this program ahead. As I mentioned in the previous video that the values are stored into the nested table collection in the same way as the arrays of any third generation programming language. This means every element of the nested table has an index associated with it, which we can use to play with its corresponding values. That's exactly what we are going to do now. Bow, 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 bow. Here in the execution section, using the DBMS output statement, we display the value stored at the first index of the nested table. Let's execute this program and see the result. As you can see, the value stored at the first position is 9. Similarly, you can change the value here and see the desired value. For example, if I want to see the value at index 2 and 3, I will modify the program like this. Note here, though the structure of collection is very similar to the array, but the index start with the 1, not with 0, which is unlike array. Also, in programming languages like Java, in array to write the index, we use square brackets, but here we use parentheses. Using a square bracket to specify the index number in nested table will slap an error on your screen. You can read my blog for more differences between array and collection. Meanwhile, let's concentrate here. Instead of writing individual statements for retrieving the values from a collection, we can use the old and trusty, that is retrieving values using loop. Let's see how. Here we used for loop to access the values of nested table. You can watch PL SQL tutorial 13 for in-depth knowledge on for loop. The iteration count of this for loop is set from 1 to 10. 10 because our nested table has 10 elements into it. And using the function count, we are making sure that this loop will execute once for each element of the collection. Let's execute. Here we have the result written from our PL SQL collection nested table. Head over to the blog to find out what data dictionary you can use to gather the information on your collections. That is the tutorial on how to create PL SQL nested table collection in Oracle database. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, then do make sure to like this video. You can also help me and my channel as well as your friends in learning by sharing this video on your social media or by any means you find convenient. Also, subscribe as many more interesting videos are coming your way. Thanks, this is Manish from RebellionRider.com.